Okay, welcome, welcome to the video. And what we do here is, my purpose is to encourage everyone to practice, to immerse yourself in practice, take refuge in practice. This is what I have been doing, trying to do, and just did a super non-dual intensive. And it was so intense that the whole day I had to just take it easy after that. But last night I had this dream that shocked me awake about 4 in the morning. Never had a dream like it. And I'm still shaking from it. So the extraordinary is taking place. There's something really going on. Exactly what it is, we will find out eventually. But it was the kind of dream that I feel like something very, very epic has happened, is happening. And so this practice is, I believe, very, very potent. It's the pearl of great price practice. It's the agree with your adversary quickly practice. It's the sell everything and follow me to the rich man practice. It's we're taking all the jewelry, all the ornamentation of arrogance and saying, I don't have it. I don't have any of it. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. And as we do this practice, this has a profound spiritual effect. But I'm okay. I'm a little bit shaken, but that's fine. I keep practicing. What happened was suddenly someone like a boss-like figure came to an area outside and they said, okay, that's it, we're done, and I'm going to light everything on fire. And somehow he caused everything to burst into flames. And I said, oh my gosh, you know, everything's burning. And then I said, well, what happened to the neighbor here? I mean, the neighbor is going to catch their garage on fire. And it might catch their house on fire. So I got a hose. I was trying to hose down the neighbor's garage so it wouldn't catch on fire. And it was just this astonishing event. Now, in looking at it, one thing I can say is I didn't see any smoke, which is quite odd, right? Normally when something's burning, there's smoke. There was no smoke. There's only flame. And the flame was on the surface, flickering everywhere. There's flickering flame on everything, all surfaces. And I didn't feel any heat either. I didn't notice anything actually, you know, charring up. I didn't notice anything charring up either. So I wonder, what kind of fire is this? Maybe it's holy fire. Maybe it's the dance of the living light that looks like flames, but is the cool flames, the flames that don't burn. But I was got all kind of freaked out, and the neighbors came and said, oh my gosh, what's going to happen? And it was a very memorable experience, to say the least. So it may be that this is a precursor, this dream is a precursor to this vision of light, which is, I say, just a preparation for the kingdom of now. As Jesus said, the kingdom of heaven is within you. It's here right now. It's near at hand, near the near. Of course, now is right now. There's no distance to it, is there? So we've been doing this intensives, and this intensive has now led to this experience while sleeping, which shook me up to the very core of my being, to say the least. and I'm within, I'm kind of like vibrating and shaking and trembling. I also had several experiences recently, but I felt this experience on the, I think it was like on the left side of my head, brain, so to speak, of a sudden like a oscillation, like a buzzing oscillation. There was no sound to it so much, but it was a feeling like a, you know, like that sort of thing. But I didn't feel anything physically, but I was aware of this, and so it must have been in some subtle body this took place. And I also had the same thing happen in my heart area the night before, where suddenly this like that, some kind of rapid like oscillation. I said, never experienced anything like that. But again, it wasn't in the physical body, actually. So we must have some sort of subtle body. Many have said that we have a subtle body. So this has never happened. These things have never happened to me before. Never experienced it. Now, so this is a very dramatic, intense time right now. No question, but All is fine. We have the tools we need. Setting the stage here. I said that today is the 21st. Congratulations of June 21st. From this date, I've said 1 year to June 21st, 2016. This is the time we must immerse ourselves in practice. This is the time when the world is going to unravel. A year of unraveling for the world. By this date in 2016, we'll either be immersed in practice or we'll have gone cuckoo. The world will have gone cuckoo. People will lose their minds, so to speak. The unraveling will be such they will have lost their minds. Means they'll become unstable. Whereas those who immerse themselves in practice, will be ultra stable. In fact, there will be a stability that is not conceptual at all. So what we're doing is we're taking all the ornaments of arrogance and sacrificing them, so to speak, selling them, melting them down. All attainment. I don't have any attainments. I don't have any accomplishments. I've never made any progress. I've never had any success. I don't have any order whatsoever. Nothing's ever been ordered. No results. I have no results. Giving all of this is our dress rehearsal for the kingdom of time and the images and concepts we have of succeeding in that. But now we're saying, no, I don't have any of that. And when we let go of all of these concepts and images of success, we will find our perfection as God created us, which has nothing to do with any kingdom of time at all. It's now, kingdom of now. So setting the stage again, there are quite a few sources that have been somewhat accurate in the past, actually, that are also saying that the unraveling is going to take place now. I've had dreams that show me this: the unraveling will take place now. There are many who are screaming, you know, asteroids going to hit and all this kind of stuff. But basically, the doomsayers are, you know, they're screaming from the rooftops. There will be an unraveling in the next year. Hopefully it won't be too severe. I hope that Greece gets bailed out. Really, I do. The meeting at the highest level of the EU is on Monday, and they're going to decide what to do. Because even now, there's no time for Greece to pay its debts off. Even if it got a loan, it doesn't have time to pay its debts off. So really, it has to be forgiven its debt somehow and truly bailed out. Otherwise, it's going to go to Russia for help and default on its loans and all this stuff. So hopefully it gets bailed out, and the unraveling of the world is a soft unraveling, you know, that it's not too dramatic. This is what we pray for, the world is unraveling. There's no question about it. Because the world is getting ready for the start of time. that believes that the kingdom of time is at hand and is ready to start. This is the core belief of most of the world, actually. You might say that 100%, almost 100% of the world isn't practicing properly at all. They're practicing according to how arrogance tells them to practice. And what we must do is to simply set arrogance aside and saying, I don't need your permission, arrogance, for anything. I'm going to practice the way that Jesus tells me to practice, the way the Holy Spirit tells me to practice. Or if you're in some other tradition, the way Buddha tells me to practice, the way the Vedas or the Upanishads tell me to practice, or whatever the guru tells me to practice. Whatever your tradition happens to be, your holy book tells you to practice this way. Well, keep asking for inspiration for right practice. And for me, I'm going along with the way that Jesus suggests to practice, because I find there's an overall very coherent context that is reasonable. And for me, I say, yeah, the promises Jesus made, I believe in those promises, absolutely. And I'm understanding, his overall context of what he's getting at. So this practice that we have of agreeing with our adversary, and then this is what we call this selling our jewelry, selling all our jewelry so we can buy the pearl of great price practice. So letting go of all our concepts of success and attainment. I don't know anything, Yes, I already know that I don't know anything. I absolutely don't know anything whatsoever. Now, this, of course, refers to how to function in the kingdom of time. I don't know anything about the kingdom of time. We've spent massive efforts trying to get ready in this dream simulation we call universe. We've been going through this dress rehearsal, trying to build up a success. We can make a successful transition into the kingdom of time. So we think we know a lot about how to do this. But in fact, there is no kingdom of time. It's nothing, doesn't exist, never will. So there's no way. We don't know anything about the kingdom of time, nothing whatsoever. But to say this frees us from this false self, that we've been building up. We've been building up this false self, which we believe will be the new self in the kingdom of time. There isn't any kingdom of time, so we need to take all the jewelry off of this false self that makes it look so attractive. Arrogance, we put all this jewelry on arrogance, all this ornamentation, like an idol, like a goddess idol, with all dripping with ornamentation. We need to take off all this ornamentation and melt it down. Say, no, I don't have any achievement whatsoever. I don't know anything. I don't know how to do anything. I don't know how to do anything. I don't know anything. I don't know how to do anything. I don't have any successful thoughts whatsoever. I don't have any thoughts about it. This is called melting down your jewelry, melting down the jewelry, melting down the jewelry of the goddess idol of arrogance. We've tried to dress arrogance up in the most beautiful clothing and ornamentation and beauty and makeup and everything. Goddess. Okay. We need to melt the goddess down. Right, this goddess idol, melt it all down, and then we see arrogance for what it is, you see. And then we say, oh, it's nothing. I don't need it. I don't need it. Whereas the world is frantically fashioning new jewelry for the goddess idol, the goddess camouflage of arrogance. Making it more and more beautiful, putting this ornamentation here and there, say, oh, look at this. Okay. So as to try and deify arrogance, thinking, because arrogance is the visor that we are imagining is going to be the new god of the kingdom of time and will advise us of how to function to be happy. So we're trying to worship this idol. Now, of course, we see, strip arrogance from all its ornamentation, and we see what it is. Ah, that's ridiculous. It's just nothing but sheer folly. There's nothing there. It's all trying to choose, make distinctions between illusions. All illusions are equally untrue. There's no distinction or judgment to make between illusions. So it's just nothing but folly. And we can just laugh and that's it. We're no longer interested in it. Don't need it. So, I was focusing last night on the light. God is the light in which I see. Now the light has come. You know, shifting perception. Seeing this light, it looks like a flame. It looks like everything's on fire. But nothing's being consumed by this fire. And so I sort of panicked in the dream a little bit. I said, but I also said, how can you burn these timbers? They're all oiled and stained and protected. I don't think it's going to be effectively burn these. Well, maybe it wasn't the kind of fire that burns. Maybe it's the kind of fire that reminds us of reality, of the mere appearanceness of everything, that it's all one appearance. So these practices are quite intense, and yet so is the collapse of the world into idol worship and believing that the time is about ready to start. That's why it's so intense right now. Is there's this core belief in the world that time is about ready to start. The kingdom of time is about ready to begin. And so final preparations need to be made. Yeah. It's like all these people are like at a bar and they you know, the bar is about ready to close and they need to get as drunk as possible. That's what they feel like. They need to be as drunk as possible before the bar closes so they can function in time in a supremely drunken, insane manner. So they're trying to get drunk on the wine the wine of arrogance, trying to get very drunk on the wine of arrogance right now. And this next year, you know, you will see but we don't need to focus on that. We need to focus on our practice. That's more intense than the news of the world, actually, is more intense. This practice I did yesterday, a super non-dual intensive, full stop in the wow, is so intense that the news of the world is just like, you know, what's that? It's a trifle. It's a mere trifle. It's ridiculous. Don't take it. It's nothing to take seriously. It's not intense at all. This practice here is so intense, it leaves you shaking. It leaves you trembling. But now we find out, you know, who are the real gung-ho spiritual practitioners, those who really want it. You know, they want the intensity. They want this intensity. It's a spiritual intensity. It's melting down the ornamentation of the goddess idol, goddess camouflage of arrogance. The goddess is just a camouflage of arrogance. It's just how we imagine as much beauty as possible, as much attractiveness as possible. Of thingness, of timeness, wrapped around arrogance, so to speak. Like arrogance is like a nothing really, it's a skeleton. And then we wrap around this idol body of a beautiful goddess of all abundance, all beauty, all ornamentation, dripping with every kind of jewel and glittering and singing beautiful songs and chants and everything. And we flowers, you know, everywhere, and this is how we're trying to disguise, camouflage arrogance. So that we can keep worshiping it. And we think we need to learn how to worship arrogance, otherwise we won't know how to function in time. Because we believe that arrogance is the new God, and that we are the creature of that God. God of time, and we're the creatures. We'll be bodies, creatures of the God of time. And we need to know how to worship this God of time properly. So this dream I had is some sort of fundamental shift. It means that something is ablaze. This person called the boss decided, said, now is the right moment, and I'm going to set this all ablaze. And it did. Everything went ablaze. This is a very, pivotal milestone type of dream. And again, I woke from it, and I couldn't settle down. I mean, I've been shaking all morning. Settle down a little, but I mean, I'm taking it in stride, okay. But still, it shook me up real good. And then I continued this practice of melting the jewelry down. I have no accomplishments whatsoever. I've never had any accomplishment. I've never set anything in order. I don't have any order. I have no achievements whatsoever. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I've never done anything whatsoever. I've never done anything whatsoever. I don't know anything. This just has a tremendous impact. So keep in mind that yes, this is very intense. It will have a tremendous impact. And this is we're in the stage now where we want to, those who are able to change the purpose of the dream, this dream simulation, from preparing for the kingdom of time to preparing for the kingdom of now, then those who are going to do this, then we need to begin to experience the dawning of this kingdom of now. So we need to push it through. We need to push it through so we can then be a lighthouse, an oasis of calm in this meltdown that is going to accelerate. This accelerated meltdown. It's kind of like, a hillside that's so saturated in water. There's been tremendous raining and floods, and it's so saturated. And you start to see the mud, and you realize, wow, the hillside is going to just, slide. The mud and everything's going to just turn into a mud flow. You can just see it's oversaturated. So that's like the world. The world's been oversaturated with arrogance and glamour. And it's so saturated, it's going to start just turning into mud and just flowing now. And that's when people, we're used to that in California, mudslides, especially Southern California. And there's hillsides that just turn into mud, yet people have their houses just buried by mudslides. The whole hill just turns into mud. Of course, we haven't had too many of those recently. But it's especially if there's no vegetation, you have wildfires, then that's really trouble, because there's nothing to hold the surface from turning into mud. So I'd say the whole world has been super saturated with this very bad meltdown of arrogance. And it's ready to start disintegrating into this mudslide. And when it does, people will suddenly take alarm. I mean, it's just like if you had a house and you're living in the Malibu hills above Malibu, in the canyons and stuff, and you have a nice house and it's been raining. There was a wildfire before. The hills are all barren. It's raining. And you start worrying, and the waters are becoming more and more muddy. And you say, uh-oh, But you think, well, I hope the hill holds, I hope it holds, I hope it holds. You know, I'm looking at it, it's a steep hill, and it's like, oh boy, I see water coming out of the base of it, and it just, I say, wow, it's really super saturated. I'm worried, but I hope it holds, I hope it holds, I hope it holds. So you still feel like, you know, I think it's got a good chance of holding. At least you have hope. You're calm. And then you start to see the hillside, you know, and it's moving faster and faster. And the mud starts hitting your house, and you say, oh gosh, the house is going to get buried. You know, then you like are very concerned. You get out. It's a different mood when you see the hill moving. So the mood of the world is likely to change very rapidly now. This is why we need those who are absolutely calm and peaceful. Nothing disintegrating in them whatsoever. Stability, actual stability. And then there will be gravitation towards those. This is what Jesus promised me in a dream. He said, there will be, you know, many will wake up overnight. And I assume those are the saints that Jesus has brought with him here. And he said, young people, there'll be young people. So there's some young people in the world who actually are saints that have returned to this world who will, overnight, they'll just wake up because they're already awake. I mean, this is maybe what Jesus was saying. Just like Ramana Maharshi just woke up like that. There's no sign that he was a saint at all before he woke up. Hardly any sign. Hardly any sign. He suddenly took a great interest in saints at a certain age, about 6 months, I think, before he woke up. But he was just a normal kid, a real athletic, and enjoyed love playing sports, and wasn't so much into studying, and nobody had an inkling that he was going to be some great saint. And he just woke up like that. So maybe this is what Jesus is saying, that in his return here, that he sent many awakened spirits into the world to take a body, and they may be just going to school, you know, just looking like they're normal, and then overnight they will wake up and be saints. And he said, there are many. So he did say, I thought he said there are many young people who will wake up overnight. Now sometimes, there are some young people, I look at them and I think that maybe they are saints actually, and they just haven't woken up yet. This is possible. But they're not really interested in spiritual stuff. Why? Because they're already awake. I mean, they've already finished. They're saints. So saints as young people may not necessarily give evidence, so much evidence of that, because they're not even trying to, they're not interested in this book or that book. They've completely dropped the whole notion of the kingdom of time altogether, and have realized their innate perfection already. So the idea of a path or need for attainment or anything doesn't arise in them at all. So they might just seem very calm, nice, a little different than others or something, you know, but they may not be that interested. And then just overnight they'll wake up. So I believe that's what Jesus told me. I couldn't understand, so I wasn't sure. Did he really say that? But he did say, I thought he said young people. Many young people will wake up overnight. And I said, what? I don't see the evidence of that. The young generation is 666 gone to hell. You know, I mean, they're totally into arrogance, the vice of arrogance, and trying to prepare for time. But he may have sent, again, many saints into this world to form, you know, to form this overall rescue mission here. That would make sense, wouldn't it? It'd be reasonable to do that. Why would he come alone? He's returning with his all his apostles and saints. And some of them may have taken a body again, and they're young people right now. And the trigger for this awakening may be right now, actually. It may be right now. So in this dream, this man says, I'm going to light a fire right now. It's time, it's quote-unquote time. Now is the moment. Now is the appropriate moment for me to light this fire. And he had this wheelbarrow full of the sack, something of a very highly flammable, something extremely flammable. And I said, what are you doing? You're lighting this fire. This is going to just go up and explode or something. But nothing happened to it, actually. It did not explode or burst into some vast fire or anything. Interesting. Maybe it's a way of saying that he's extremely flammable. Spiritually flammable. Able to cause the vision of light. You know, the vision of light. Living light. Vision of oneness too. Now, also last night, before I went to sleep, I suddenly began imagining people as bodies, as if they had all these Christmas tree lights strung on them. I said, huh? And so everyone I saw was walking around like a Christmas tree. They were all ornamented with lights, bright lights, like Christmas trees. So I was looking at the lights. I didn't really even see the bodies so much. It was like the bodies were all dark. Everyone was like wearing dark clothing. They're all dark, but they all were wearing these Christmas tree ornaments. Bright lights, Christmas tree lights, not ornaments, lights. And then I said, wow. And I began imagining that they're wearing more and more lights, that their whole bodies were covered with these bright, shining lights. And so, you know, white lights, I began imagining. And so this is how I was viewing bodies now, as light. And I said, yeah, this is great. This is how I'd like to see bodies. It's just light. So these are very significant milestones that we're reaching just in time. So I had this very significant dream on June 21st, 2015. And this is the key day that I've been aiming for quite some time. Almost a year, actually, of intense practice and effort. Practice, really. We need to have those in the world who now can exhibit this vast calm, a la Ramana Maharshi. Otherwise, people will start freaking out. The whole hillside is crumbling. That is true. It's all going to crumble down. And we have to not be bothered by that at all. I mean, this is going to happen. The world is giving so many signs that there's a meltdown in this world in many ways. We have to be absolutely unaffected by it. You know, just great. It's all good. I don't have any achievements whatsoever. See, we co-opt the whole thing. We melt down the ornaments of arrogance on our own. Practicing in a positive way. Like, yes, yes, yes. This is great. I love doing this. Nothing I like better than melting these ornaments down. Melting the idols' ornaments down. The melting of the idols' ornaments. Practice. The crown of accomplishment. I have absolutely no accomplishment. I've never accomplished anything whatsoever. I've never accomplished anything whatsoever. And the shock we feel from this actually is the shock of liberation. It's a positive shock. Don't get frightened. See, if you panic and get fearful of it, then it becomes too difficult. But if you're just saying, yes, this is wonderful. Yes, I've never accomplished anything whatsoever. I've never done anything. I've absolutely no success whatsoever. I'm totally unsuccessful in what? Preparing for time, right? How can we be successful in preparing for time? It's impossible. So we co-opt the whole thing. And keep in mind that arrogance is trying to prove that it can do what the Holy Spirit can do, that it can make you bring enlightenment to you also in time. So people are talking about this asteroid hitting on September 24th, 25th, and setting the whole world on fire, with many fragments setting the whole world on fire. Well, this would be arrogance's version of the spiritual, seeing the spiritual light, the whole world ablaze with spiritual light. Arrogance saying, well, I can do that too. I can do that. You know, you can still follow arrogance. I'll do that too. But what arrogance is trying to do is literally set the world on physical, electromagnetic fire that burns everything. We certainly don't want that. That's crazy, right? But it's in competition. It thinks it's in competition with reality, and that it has to show you that I can do that too. But it ends up being a fumbling bumbler, to say the least. I'm a moron. Maniac, moron. Arrogance really is crazy. And the way we practice is agree with whatever arrogance says in terms of trying to address us. We just agree with it quickly. Agree with your adversary quickly. Love your enemy. So whatever arrogance says, yes, because you cannot argue with total insanity. When you argue with insanity, you yourself feel insane. You start believing you're insane. So arrogance is completely insane. So whatever it says, you say yes, 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 yes. Don't get into any conversation with arrogance. Don't get into any struggle with it whatsoever. Just maintain a smiling, happy outlook. Arrogance says, I'm going to dominate you. Yes, you're going to dominate me. I am your God. Yes, you are my God. My advice is the right advice. Yes, your advice is the right advice. And you don't give it any thought whatsoever. You know what your response is. Yes, I agree. And don't give it any thought. Don't think, now what is arrogance trying to say here? And now, is this true? And no, just say, yes, I agree. Yes, I agree. This is one of the great keys to liberating yourself. And from the purpose, the old purpose of preparing for time, and now the new purpose, except the new purpose of preparing for the kingdom of now, no time. No, time will never start. Preparing to accept that time will never start, and thus we need no preparation whatsoever for it. It's a key, this agree with your adversary quickly practice, and then melting the ornaments of the idol down. Melting the idol's ornaments down practice is a I have done absolutely nothing. I've never done anything. See, melting that ornament down of doing. You've done so much, you know, and to prepare for time, you've done so much. Arrogance is telling you, and you say no. Say, yes, I know I've done. I've never done anything. I've never prepared at all. I haven't done any preparation whatsoever. That's another powerful one. This is a very powerful practice. I've never done any preparation whatsoever. I have no preparation whatsoever. Yes, I have no preparation whatsoever. The intensity of this is leaving me almost speechless. To say that you have absolutely no preparation and celebrate and accept and say yes and keep asserting it. You know, this is like absolutely contrary to all advice the ego, arrogance, which is the voice of arrogance, has ever given us. See, we have arrogance, which is the advisor. We have the ego, which is the voice of arrogance. And we have the idol, full of ornamentation, which is the camouflage of arrogance, trying to make arrogance seem attractive to us. We have those three aspects that we must let go of those, see through those. So our practices are engaged with doing that. So I have absolutely no preparation whatsoever. So we're totally devaluing arrogance, the idol, the camouflage, the ornamentation of camouflage, and the idol. We're devaluing the idol camouflage, and we're devaluing the ego, the voice of arrogance. Devaluing those three and these practices, and not asking for their permission. We don't go to arrogance for permission. We don't go to the idol. We call it the goddess, because the goddess is, generally speaking, the idol we make is one of a goddess. It's more attractive to everyone. We think that, you know, the beautiful mother, the beautiful goddess, beautiful, you know, full of bounty and nourishment and love and affection and all this kind of stuff, and ornamentation. When we try to make an idol out of a man, the male type of thing, it doesn't seem nearly as attractive as we make the female idol with all this ornamentation and fashion. And, you know, that's why fashion magazines are full of models. And, you know, the models, the women that are looking at these fashion magazines, they say, wow, this is so attractive. I wish I could look like that. So the idol is generally in our psyche. It's a goddess. So melting down the ornamentation of the idol goddess, not listening to the voice of arrogance, the ego, and not asking permission from arrogance. So we're saying, devaluing all those three, that unholy triple alliance there, right? Three aspects of defensiveness that are so vexatious to us. I don't have any preparation whatsoever, meaning they haven't done anything to prepare me. I'm saying that I've never done anything. I have zero preparation for time, nothing. I have no preparation whatsoever. So if your advisor has done nothing to prepare you, then they must be a pretty terrible advisor, right? They must have no value to you. So what you're essentially saying is the arrogance, you have no value to me. So far, I certainly don't need you. Why would I need that which has absolutely no value to me whatsoever? This is just resonating so profoundly in the core of my being, so to speak, deep down. This is a tremendous wow. So I have no preparation whatsoever. I have no order whatsoever. I don't have any order at all. This is another one that's really shocking, because we keep thinking that the way to dwell in the kingdom of time is to learn how to order everything properly, how to arrange. I don't have any knowledge of arrangement. I don't have any knowledge of arranging anything. I've never arranged anything. I've never ordered anything. Order meaning putting things in place. Or you can also use it like ordering things. I don't know. I don't have any orders for anyone. The word can have two meanings. I don't have any orders for anyone or anything. I have no orders for anything whatsoever, and I've never arranged or ordered anything at all. I don't know how to arrange anything. I have no knowledge of how to arrange anything. Now, we could have always practiced this way. It's just we didn't have the urgency. So you might be thinking, wow, how can I practice this way? Well, when the urgency is upon you, then you may very well start practicing. And the urgency is certainly upon us and will become very apparent. I just felt the urgency at a distance, so to speak, before it got super bad. It's kind of like a huge earthquake, and then I realized, uh-oh, there's going to be a tremendous tsunami going to come and hit this beach from this earthquake. So the urgency is right there. Where is the urgency? When the tsunami hits the beach or when the earthquake happens that generates the tsunami? Well, for me, it's when the earthquake happens to generate the tsunami. That's when the urgency is. And there was this social earthquake happened in the 60s and the early 70s. A tremendous social earthquake arose that now is this vast tsunami heading towards the beach, and it's about ready to hit the beach. So, you know, you better already practice your evacuation of the beach, getting out of there and getting to higher ground. You better, you know, have been practicing that. Now, it's still possible when you see a tsunami coming in to get off the beach and get on a jeep and get to higher ground. Absolutely. The important thing is just don't sit there like a deer in headlights thinking that, oh, this is my salvation. This tsunami is my salvation. No, it's not. It's turmoil. And of course, arrogance tells us that turmoil is our salvation. That's how you ultimately function in time, is to be completely confused. Total chaos. That way you can't judge whether you're being successful or not. You see, this is its ultimate advice of arrogance, is to be in total mental chaos. Because then the arrogance will say, well, you can't say that I'm wrong, because you're so confused, you don't know what's wrong or right. You know, it could be right. You just are incapable of knowing whether it's right or not. And then arrogance says, it's the ultimate, that's the ultimate advice of the poseur. You know, the poseur says, well, if they just are completely confused, then how can they say that I'm not giving the right advice? They just don't know whether it's right or not. This is its out. You know, this is the out of arrogance. This is the joker up its sleeve. So this is what it wants to bring, is utter chaos. That's its final, that's what it's aiming for, actually. It loves to build up civilizations, and then also loves to collapse them. And it tells you, that's your final lesson for time. That once you abide in this mental chaos, then the kingdom of time will start. And you won't know whether it started or not. You see? This is this trick. The kingdom of time will never start. But our advisor, arrogance, tells us that if you just enter into total mental chaos, you won't know whether the kingdom of time has started or not. So you might say, well, it might have started. I don't know. I just don't know whether it started or not. Therefore, arrogance can say, well, you can't say that I'm wrong, because you don't know whether it started or not. And so you might as well just assume that it did. The only problem is you would have to stay in that utter mental chaos permanently to assert that maybe it started. That's the most you can say. Well, maybe it started, but I have no way of knowing. That's arrogance's joker up its sleeve, that this is what it's aiming for. And of course, arrogance is all confidence, saying, yeah, I have the way. I know the way. And so people believing in arrogance are very confident right now, saying, yeah, like, I'm sure we're going to succeed here. We're going to succeed with this. Time is going to start, right? Because arrogance is very confident. But actually, arrogance is like a super criminal, I mean, deceptive, and it's very confident that we can have this mental chaos, and we won't know whether time has started or not. So there's no way to say that arrogance is wrong, you see. That's its confidence. But as a matter of fact, I know for a fact that we cannot abide in total mental chaos. We can only experience it for just an instant, and then we let go of it. And this is what I've been through, personally been through experiencing this. And then I knew that this will never work. What arrogance is planned cannot work. And how silly that plan is, of merely saying that it's right merely because we can't prove that it's wrong, because we're so confused, there's no way to know one way or the other. This is its refuge. This is the refuge that arrogance is leading itself to. This is where it hides, and it demands that we all be completely confused to protect it, its supposed rightness. You know, protect its ego, so to speak, protect its image. That's the price that arrogance demands of us, is total mental chaos, in order to, so we can feel like, well, maybe I was following the right advisor. I don't know, because I'm completely confused. Yeah, but that confusion is hideous. Mental chaos is hideous. You cannot abide in it. But that's the price that arrogance is demanding of us, to just maintain its plausibility factor. That's all it is plausibility. Arrogance is, you know, never really claims that it's right. It always claims that it's this is quite plausible, that this is right, right? It's very plausible. So it's really teaching plausibility. But to the ultimate goal of that is just to be completely confused, complete mental chaos. So you can say, well, anything's plausible. Yeah, it's plausible that arrogance could be right, because I can't tell. There's no way for me to tell. And then that's sort of like the end game of plausibility, okay? No, not sort of. That is the end game of plausibility. That's its end game. Now, all this talk is very well and good, and all this practice, etc., but ultimately, the world is going to need those who are oases of calm. They have to feel it. They're going to have to intuit it, you know. Otherwise, the situation is going to run away with everyone. Like a runaway freight train. So I don't know anything whatsoever. This is a different... I don't even know mental chaos, you see? I don't know mental chaos at all. In other words, I'm not prepared at all. Remember, arrogance is preparing us for mental chaos. So we would say, I don't have any preparation whatsoever. This is a statement of liberation. I don't have any order whatsoever. Mental chaos is based on trying to order stuff, right? But just you're all confused. You don't know how to order it. But I'm saying, I don't know anything about order. I don't know anything about order whatsoever. See, this is liberation from arrogance and plausibility. I don't know anything about any order. I don't know any order at all. I don't know anything about accomplishment. I don't have any accomplishments. I don't have any order. any success? All of this brings arrogance out into the open. And this is having a tremendous effect upon me. At some subtle level, I can feel all sorts of kind of stuff going on. It's already, you know, subtle in some way. I don't need to describe it so much, but it can feel the reverberation subtly. And I never really put my attention on it or try to sustain any attention on it. Just keep practicing, and when the wow is too strong, I just you know, coast for a while. That's all. I don't know any attainment whatsoever. I don't have any attainment whatsoever. Keep in mind, the attainment that arrogance has been teaching us, leading us, guiding us towards is total mental chaos. So you say, I don't have any attainment whatsoever. And keep in mind, what attainment does perfection need to be perfect? Doesn't need to attain anything to be perfect. What attainment does now need to be now? None whatsoever. Now doesn't need to be confused in order to presume that it's now. It's only arrogance that needs this cover of confusion so it can at least assert plausibility, continue to assert plausibility. And don't struggle with it. Whatever you hear, don't struggle with it. Just let whatever seeps in, seep in. It's kind of like you're immersing yourself in a jacuzzi, a pool. Just calmly just sit there and you know, gradually, like if you're like overheated on a hot day, you get in a pool and you cool down gradually. And it just happens imperceptibly. Gradually you cool down. Or if you want to heat up and go in a hot jacuzzi, gradually you heat up. It's like turning on the air conditioner. If your house is real hot, you turn it on. It takes a while. Gradually the house cools down, and in a couple hours you find, oh, it's cool here. We finally did get our air conditioner fixed. Which is good going forward. I think next week is supposed to be pretty hot. Right now, it's a delightful day here, just amazing. I don't know anything. This is by far and away the most potent practice I've ever experienced. It's like super strong medicine. I've never done anything. I have never done anything. I don't know anything about order. I don't have any order at all. See, there are no layers and levels in reality whatsoever. There's nothing to be put into order. You don't have to order reality. It's already flawlessly one perfection. So I don't know anything about, I don't have any order at all. You see, the shock of this is so strong I can hardly move. I don't feel like moving. As I said, when you practice, the first thing you do is give up your intention to move. Set it aside for a while. Say, I have no intention to move at all. And then you can practice this way, and you will feel like you don't really feel like moving at all. You're kind of like stunned. So the basics are very important to practice. Get used to the basics, and then you can then get deep in your melting the ornaments of the idol down. You can melt more and more and more. So this is indeed the most intense practice I've ever been engaged in. But I'm still fine. You know, just sitting here, not moving. All my senses are fine. My mind is calm, you know. It's not all full of agitation at all. They're just an intense, you know, deep reverberation. Intense wow feeling, that's all. Ah, here's another one. I don't have any agreements whatsoever. I have no agreements. I've never made any agreements. I don't know of any agreements. Oh, obviously, I don't know of anything agreeable. I have no attainment whatsoever. I have absolutely no attainment. There's absolutely nothing that I need to know. There's absolutely nothing that I need to know. And I don't know anything. I don't know anything. That's quite odd. I had just had an image popped into my mind of some young man in a dark closet, bent over at the waist with the head down, except there wasn't any head there. There's no head. So I saw a body with no head at all. It's not that the head had been cut off at all or anything, there just wasn't any head. So I've never made any headway. I don't have any headway. I don't have any momentum. I don't have any head at all. I don't even have a head. I don't have any headway. I have never made any headway. I don't have any headway whatsoever. I don't have a speck of momentum. I have absolutely no momentum whatsoever. So, keep it full stop on the wow. I started to drift just a little bit there. I caught myself. I have absolutely no momentum whatsoever. None. I have zero momentum. Zero attainment. Zero recognition. Zero success. Zero accomplishment. Zero results. Zero order. Zero answers. Zero plausibility. I have no plausibility whatsoever. The It's like casting these into a furnace and you just watch them melt down. It's like, oh my God, that, you know, it's shocking to see all your jewelry being melted down, right? Especially since you've been using it. It's like the key to, do you think, to your, all your happiness and success is to have that idol, have all this wonderful jewelry, and now you're watching it, you know, melt into the furnace of gold, and you're like, wow. It's very, very shocking. I have zero plausibility. That's the one, yeah. I have no plausibility whatsoever. I have no discernment. I have absolutely no discernment. I have no plausibility. I have no discernment. And of course, we're talking about discerning differences between illusions, discerning time. Time doesn't exist, so how can we discern it? So I say, I have no discernment. Melt down the ornament of discernment. Melt down the images and concepts. We have a discernment. I have no discernment. What kind of discernment does perfection need? We don't need discernment. We know. So I don't have any discernment. I have no discernment. I have no plausibility. I have no familiarity. I have no familiarity. So we've gone plausibility, discernment, familiarity here. We're melting down these the jewels of the idol, the ornaments of the idol, which is just a camouflage for arrogance. So plausibility, discernment. Familiarity. Plausibility, discernment, familiarity. I have no familiarity. I have no familiarity at all. I have no familiarity. There's nothing that's familiar to me. See, that's an attention getter right there. There is nothing that is familiar to me. I have no familiarity. I've never made any headway. I've never made any headway. I have no plausibility. I have no purpose. I have no discernment. I have no familiarity. I have no headway. I have no body. We can try this. I have no success. I have no body. Try this, try it. I have no body. Or, I don't know anybody. I don't know anybody. Anybody means anybody. I don't know anybody. I don't know anybody. I do not know anybody. I have no knowledge. I have no knowledge whatsoever. And of course, they're meaning knowledge of time. Can't have. How can you have knowledge of what doesn't exist? So I have no knowledge. Absolutely no knowledge. I don't know anybody. I don't know how to do anything. I don't know how to do anything. I don't even know how to die. I don't know how to die. I don't know how to be born. I don't know how to live. I don't know how to live. There you go. I don't know anything about living. Of course, they're referring to the imagined living in the King of Time. I don't know anything about living. I don't know how to live. I don't know anything about living. I don't know anything about life. I don't know anything about death. I don't know anything about birth. I don't know anything about afterlife. I don't know anything. I don't know life. I don't know death. I don't know birth. I don't know afterlife. I don't know life. I don't know afterlife. I don't know anything. I don't know any possibility. I don't know any possibility. I don't know anything about possibilities. I don't know any plausibilities. I don't know any possibilities. I don't know any world. I don't know anything about the world. I don't know about worlds at all. I don't know worlds. I don't know universes. I don't have any success whatsoever. I don't have any success. So we get these intensives just at the right moment here in terms of what's going on in the world. We now have the tools and the right tools for the job, no doubt about it. You know, if there's a forest of dark trees suddenly springing up everywhere, well, you got a chainsaw and keep it clear. Keep it clear. Our weeds are, all these weeds are coming up. You can, you know, you got a weed whacker and just easily take care of it quickly. I don't know how to do anything. I don't know how to do anything. I've never known anybody. I can't see anything. I cannot see anything. Of course, how can we see nothing? How can we see the kingdom of time doesn't exist? Never be able to. So, it's a great thing. I can't see anything. I absolutely cannot see anything of the kingdom of time. Absolutely not. But I certainly can see a dream preparing me for the kingdom of now. I can certainly see that. But we're melting the jewelry, the ornaments of the idol here that make the idol seem attractive, which is really just the covering, the cover for arrogance, which is just our desire to be greater than God, change reality. There's absolutely nothing that I can do. Yes, I already know that there's absolutely nothing that I can ever do. There's absolutely nothing that I want. I don't want anything. I do not want anything. So I'm testing all this out here on myself. I don't want anything. There's nothing that I want. I don't want anything. There's nothing whatsoever that I want. I don't want anything. Anything. There's nothing that I want. Absolutely nothing that I want. There's nothing that I could ever want. There's nothing that I could ever want. I don't know anything about being well. I don't know anything about being well. Yes, I don't know anything about being well. I don't know anything about wellness. I don't know anything about wellness. There goes another strand of diamonds into the furnace, another strand of pearls. Ornamentation, right? Wellness. I don't know anything about wellness. I don't know wellness, period. I don't know wellness. I don't know anything about wellness. I don't know anything about the body. I don't know anything about wellness. I don't know anything about birth. I don't know anything about death. I don't know anything about afterlife. I don't know anything about wellness. I don't know anything about survival. I don't know anything about survival. I don't know anything about survival. Just taking another ornament off the idol, you see. I don't know anything. I don't know anything about survival. I have no knowledge of survival whatsoever. What are we doing here? Oh. This is the very definition of intensive. Anyone who could sail through all of this without any feeling of wow at all, well, they're already enlightened then. They're already enlightened. And of course, they know they don't know anything about enlightenment. They just are enlightened. You know, they are just, I am. Just I am. So, for the rest of us, this is, you know, it has great intensity. Now, I'm sure I'm trying to make it as strong as possible because we need to get to the depths of this here. And I need to make sure that it's all fine. All these practices are fine, you know. And but I'm sure for most it's like, whoa, you know, like, wow, this is just like, mega intense, and I don't know, you know, it is mega intense. We could say, I don't know anything about intensity. I don't know intensity at all. I don't know anything about intensity. I don't know anything about troubles. I don't know any troubles. I don't know any solutions. I don't know anything about solutions. I don't have any solutions. I don't have any solutions. I don't have any troubles. I don't know anything about troubles. I don't know anything about solutions. I don't know anything about remedies. I don't have any remedies. I don't have any answers. I don't have any solutions. I don't know anything about solutions. I don't know anything about remedies. I don't have any solutions whatsoever. Don't even know anything about solutions. So by and large, I've been able to keep my mind full stop on the wow. Occasionally little things kind of come in and then I'm able to get back to practicing, push them aside. I don't know success. I don't know anything about success. I've never had any success. Isn't that true? I mean, have we had any success preparing for time? How could we? How could we? How can we have success preparing for what will never be, which has never been, and we have no, there can be no reality to it whatsoever? So there's no concept about what doesn't exist that's any more valid than any other concept. They're all equally invalid. So how can I have success ordering those concepts into equally invalid concepts? What kind of success can I experience? So I don't know anything about success. I've never had any success. So we embrace the intensity of the times, this era, this stage of the world. We embrace it, but we're embracing the intensity of spiritual practice is what we're really embracing. So we don't need the other world. How could we be interested in the other? This is so much more intense than anything the world can throw at us, really. Yeah, really. Other stuff is like child's play. It's not even worth our attention. This is really worthy of our attention. This sort of practice and intensity is very much worthy of our attention. It's an attention getter. Stuff in the world, just trifles, ridiculous. It's not really worth our attention. Do is we stay poised here. We stay poised. I don't know anything about victory. I've never had any victory. I've never triumphed. I don't have any triumphs at all. I don't have any accomplishments at all. Ah. The little insect has started. The little cicada. I started this little song. It means the heat has gotten to a certain level. It only starts when the heat gets a certain level. Maybe the heat and the sunlight, I don't know, there's a trigger for it and it kicks in. So, embrace the intensity of these practices. Otherwise, we'll embrace the intensity of the world meltdown. We don't want to be embracing that. It's already ridiculous levels of ridiculousness. So we say, well, we got our hands full with the spiritual practice, I'm telling you. Tremendous intensity. So we got no extra attention for, the world's meltdowns and whatever problems. I don't know anything about problems. I don't have any problems. Again, the wow intensity is so strong. This is the strongest practice ever. I don't have any problems. I don't know anything about problems. So, it's off the charts. We don't even need to measure it. Don't try to measure it. Never try to measure the wow. Just whatever wow is there, you just don't struggle with it. Just say, okay, that's great. So, this is like irreversible. wowness, you know, irreversible wowness. Once you've experienced this, you're never the same again. I mean, to realize you can do this, you can actually focus your attention on this, you'll never be the same again. We've crossed the Rubicon, as it were. We've crossed over the Rubicon here. Now we've been able to do this practice. We're melting down the ornaments of the idol of arrogance, and this is crossing the Rubicon, absolutely. So we don't know what the ramifications of this will be. We don't even try to think about it. That's why the full stop in the wild. We're just coasting. Let's just coast here for a while. I don't have to figure anything out about how this will play out, what the ramifications are. No need to. So we're hitting the ground running on this next year now. We're in this next year phase, and we are hitting the ground running. People talk about rapture is coming, all this. I don't know. I don't worry about that. We just keep practicing. Right practice is the way to go. Take refuge in right practice. And then we do right practice, then we're bound to have the best, you know, outcome, so to speak. Yeah. Oh, I don't want Google to grab that song. It's so picky. Yeah. Have a car driving by at, you know, 40 miles an hour with a song on it. It'll grab that and say, hey, that's copyright. You can't have that on your video. Fatigue is trying to set in, you know, from the shock. So you have to try and set that aside. Don't try to think about what kind of success this will bring. Just let it happen. It will be there. Whatever it is, it will just be there. So we don't have to worry about it. Just stay focused in the now. Stay focused in the wow. Stay focused in the now. Stay focused in the wow. Just coasting along. Try not to fidget, you know. Try not to be rearranging your clothing, all right? None of that. No grooming, no arranging of clothing. Keep the hands to hands, just. Now, the fallback is, I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. Or, I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. So when you start getting fatigued or you start getting off track, you just go right back to that one. And we wind down our practice with that. We're not going to do any more except to, I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. I'm not a body, I'm free. God is the light in which I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. God is the light in which I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. God is the light in which I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. God is the light in which I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. The light is here for me to see. I am the light that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. I am the light that I see. I am the light that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. I am the light that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. I am a still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. How are we doing? Pretty good, huh? I am not a body, I'm free. I am the light of God to see. I am not a body, I'm free. The light of God is what I see. I am not a body, I'm free. The light of God is what I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. The light of God is what I see. So, we're segueing out of the intensity of our practice. Best practice ever. So it's great to have that under your belt, you know. It's like, wow. Wow, I can do this. Yeah, I can do this. I can survive this. I did it. I mean, I can do this. Yes. I'm okay. Everything's fine. I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still exactly as God created me. I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created spirit to be. I'm not a body, I'm free. God is the light in which I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops that tree that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops these shrubs that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops that sidewalk that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops this plant that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops this computer that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops this space that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops this day that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops this now that I see. I'm not a body, I'm free. My holiness envelops this roof that I see. I'm not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops that house that I see. I am not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops that leaf that I see. I am not a body. I am free. My holiness envelops that bird chirping that I hear, see. I am not a body. I am free. My holiness envelops that breeze that I see. I am not a body. I am free. My holiness envelops these thoughts that I see. I am not a body. I am free. My holiness envelops those flowers that I see. Wow. I am not a body. I am free. My holiness envelops this world that I see. I am not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops that insect that I see. I am not a body. I am free. My holiness envelops that mountain that I see. Yeah, I see a little bit of a mountain from here. It's very nice. I see sky. I see mountain. I see trees. Shrubs. I am not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops everything that I see. I am not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops everything that I see. I am not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops that bark that I see. I'm not a body, I am free. My holiness envelops everything that I see. Tree liberated in the now. Pebble liberated in the now. Stone liberated in the now. Mat liberated in the now. Block liberated in the now. Concrete liberated in the now. Rock liberated in the now. Leaf liberated in the now. Basket liberated in the now. Wire liberated in the now. Leaves liberated in the now. Vegetation liberated in the now. Air liberated in the now. Light liberated in the now. Buildings liberated in the now. Mountains liberated in the now. Sky liberated in the now. Birds liberated in the now. Creatures liberated in the now. Music liberated in the now. Sound liberated in the now. Falling leaves liberated in the now. New growth liberated in the now. Decay liberated in the now. Death liberated in the now. Life liberated in the now. Flowers liberated in the now. Ornamentation liberated in the now. Cloth liberated in the now. Carpet liberated in the now. Plastics liberated in the now. Metal liberated in the now. Metal liberated in the now. Plastic liberated in the now. Graphite liberated in the now. Materials liberated in the now. Water liberated in the now. Electronics liberated in the now. Heat liberated in the now. Gravity liberated in the now. Feelings liberated in the now. Sensations liberated in the now. Now liberated in the now. This liberated in the now. That liberated in the now. Effort liberated in the now. Relaxation liberated in the now. Thought liberated in the now. Thinking liberated in the now. Clarity liberated in the now. Drama liberated in the now. Relationship liberated in the now. How are we doing? Palm tree liberated in the now. Sand liberated in the now. Grass liberated in the now. Gravel liberated in the now. Hills liberated in the now. Coastline liberated in the now. Boats liberated in the now. Bridges liberated in the now. Lighting liberated in the now. Glass liberated in the now. Caterpillars liberated in the now. Twigs liberated in the now. Dew liberated in the now. Fog liberated in the now. Stillness liberated in the now. walking, liberated in the now. Sitting, liberated in the now. Watching, liberated in the now. Activity, liberated in the now. Motion, liberated in the now. Trains, liberated in the now. Fences, liberated in the now. Trees, liberated in the now. Landscapes, liberated in the now. Breakage, liberated in the now. Trash, liberated in the now. Food, liberated in the now. Bodies, liberated in the now. Places, liberated in the now. Spaces, liberated in the now. Processes, liberated in the now. Forms, liberated in the now. Times, liberated in the now. Concerns, liberated in the now. Agitations, liberated in the now. Learning, liberated in the now. Memory, liberated in the now. Future, liberated in the now. Past, liberated in the now. Imagination, liberated in the now. Dreaming, liberated in the now. Color, liberated in the now. Paint, liberated in the now. Reflections, liberated in the now. Shadows, liberated in the now. Variance, liberated in the now. Differences, liberated in the now. Judgment, liberated in the now. Images, liberated in the now. Fear, liberated in the now. Analysis, liberated in the now. Troubles, liberated in the now. Problems, liberated in the now. Inventions, liberated in the now. Weather, liberated in the now. Traveling, liberated in the now. Money, liberated in the now. Survival, liberated in the now. Awkwardness, liberated in the now. Awkwardness, liberated in the now. Age, liberated in the now. Endings, liberated in the now. Beginnings, liberated in the now. Strife, liberated in the now. Insecurities, liberated in the now. Debts, liberated in the now. Bills, liberated in the now. Energy, liberated in the now. Qualities, liberated in the now. stabilities, liberated in the now. World liberated in the now. Solar system liberated in the now. Sun liberated in the now. Galaxy liberated in the now. Universe liberated in the now. Atoms liberated in the now. Electrons liberated in the now. Spaciousness liberated in the now. Darkness liberated in the now. Light liberated in the now. So we're giving it everything we got right now. Why not? It's a new phase starting now, right now. New phase. All beginnings liberate in the now. All starts liberated in the now. It's the startless start, the beginningless beginning. The practice free practice. The entry free entry. The effortless effort. Abidance liberated in the now. Non-duality liberated in the now. Concepts liberated in the now. Ideas liberated in the now. Words liberated in the now. Journeys liberated in the now. Destiny liberated in the now. Fate liberated in the now. Karma liberated in the now. Rebirths liberated in the now. Struggle liberated in the now. Reactions liberated in the now. Consequences liberated in the now. Stress liberated in the now. Happiness liberated in the now. Now liberated in the now. Liberated in the now. Liberated in the now. Programs liberated in the now. News liberated in the now. Events liberated in the now. Situations liberated in the now. Circumstances liberated in the now. Outcomes liberated in the now. Complaints liberated in the now. Disagreements liberated in the now. Conflict liberated in the now. Arguments liberated in the now. Propaganda liberated in the now. Corporations liberated in the now. New world orders liberated in the now. Beliefs liberated in the now. Politics liberated in the now. Social issues liberated in the now. Change liberated in the now. Opportunity liberated in the now. Objections liberated in the now. Interruptions liberated in the now. Blockages liberated in the now. Interference liberated in the now. Friends liberated in the now. family, liberated in the now. Errands, liberated in the now. Shopping, liberated in the now. Cars, liberated in the now. Machines, liberated in the now. Gasoline, liberated in the now. Oil, liberated in the now. Pharmaceuticals, liberated in the now. Drugs, liberated in the now. Altered states, liberated in the now. Sleep, liberated in the now. Illness, liberated in the now. Affliction, liberated in the now. Terminality, liberated in the now. Abnormality, liberated in the now. Normality, liberated in the now. Everything, liberated in the now. Allness, liberated in the now. Oneness, liberated in the now. How are we doing here? It's hard to see, but it's... Time, liberated in the now. Clock, liberated in the now. Order, liberated in the now. Counting, liberated in the now. Mathematics, liberated in the now. Calculation, liberated in the now. Trepidation, liberated in the now. Activity, liberated in the now. Recreation, liberated in the now. Play, liberated in the now. Fun, liberated in the now. Meditation, liberated in the now. Peace, liberated in the now. Attainment, liberated in the now. Success, liberated in the now. Smartphones, liberated in the now. Tablets, liberated in the now. Texting, liberated in the now. Social media, liberated in the now. Videos, liberated in the now. Pine cones, liberated in the now. Seeds, liberated in the now. DNA, liberated in the now. Genetics, liberated in the now. Science, liberated in the now. Experiments, liberated in the now. Conclusions, liberated in the now. Facts, liberated in the now. Books, liberated in the now. Pictures, liberated in the now. Art, liberated in the now. Dance, liberated in the now. Romance, liberated in the now. Love, liberated in the now. Passion, liberated in the now. Depression, liberated in the now. Split mind, liberated in the now. Disassociation, liberated in the now. Confusion, liberated in the now. Chaos, liberated in the now. Sadness, liberated in the now. States of mind, liberated in the now. Mind, liberated in the now. Spirit, liberated in the now. Tides, liberated in the now. Oceans, liberated in the now. Moons, liberated in the now. Rotation, liberated in the now. Orbit, liberated in the now. Comets, liberated in the now. Asteroids, liberated in the now. Fire, liberated in the now. Steam, liberated in the now. Waves, liberated in the now. Fragments, liberated in the now. Impacts, liberated in the now. Collisions, liberated in the now. Accidents, liberated in the now. Meltdowns, liberated in the now. Floods, liberated in the now. Catastrophes, liberated in the now. Earthquakes, liberated in the now. Famine, liberated in the now. Drought, liberated in the now. Liberation, liberated in the now. Liberation, liberated in the now. Voting, liberated in the now. Inoculations, liberated in the now. Vaccinations, liberated in the now. Epidemics, liberated in the now. Plagues, liberated in the now. Ecosystems, liberated in the now. Climate, liberated in the now. Climate change, liberated in the now. Ice, liberated in the now. Volatility, liberated in the now. Extinction, liberated in the now. Trauma, liberated in the now. Terror, liberated in the now. Religion, liberated in the now. Materialism, liberated in the now. Communism, liberated in the now. Capitalism, liberated in the now. Socialism, liberated in the now. Social engineering, liberated in the now. Predictions, liberated in the now. Doom, liberated in the now. Wars, liberated in the now. Weapons, liberated in the now. Deaths, liberated in the now. Attacks, liberated in the now. Imprisonments, liberated in the now. Endangerment, liberated in the now. Evacuations, liberated in the now. Immigrations, liberated in the now. Activity, liberated in the now. Damage, liberated in the now. Breakage, liberated in the now. Worn outness, liberated in the now. Weakness, liberated in the now. Injuries, liberated in the now. Needs, liberated in the now. Brightness, liberated in the now. Snow, liberated in the now. Elevations, liberated in the now. Dreams, liberated in the now. Nightmares, liberated in the now. Crying, liberated in the now. Talking, liberated in the now. Silence, liberated in the now. Days, liberated in the now. History, liberated in the now. Epochs, liberated in the now. Ages, liberated in the now. Advancements, liberated in the now. Evolution, liberated in the now. Creation, liberated in the now. Homework, liberated in the now. Games, liberated in the now. Movies, liberated in the now. Television, liberated in the now. Enlightenment, liberated in the now.
How are we doing?
Doing pretty well here, actually. That's great. Wow. Wow. Wow, liberated in the now. Wow, liberated in the now. I am 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 liberated in the now. All is liberated in the now. All is liberated in the now. All is liberated in the now. I am liberated in the now. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created spirit to be. I am liberated in the now. 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 All is liberated in the now. I am liberated in the now. All is liberated in the now. I am 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 liberated in the now. Yes, I am liberated in the now. Yes, I am liberated in the now.